Are you nervous?
Yes.
Hello, people of the internet. Today I'm going to look at another shop space. If you missed the last video where I went to look at pretty much my dream shop, there's a link up above to that video. I'll get to that a little bit more, what's going on with that situation. Right now I'm on my way to meet up with the boys to go look at another shop. Fred, Brandon, and myself just went to check out this next property. It's got 7 bay doors. 7. It's at the end of the runway for Davis Monthan Air Force Base, which I don't know if that might not be the greatest for recording YouTube videos, having aircraft flying overhead. What's over here? Fox body Mustang. Some Chrysler, there's a couple Fox bodies, some Chrysler 300s. I think that's the lowrider from Training Day, just not nice. Was that Monte Carlo or something? I don't know older American cars that well. There's junkyards all on the other side of that, all way back there. And then there's like some storage unit inside here that wouldn't be ours to use. It doesn't seem terribly loud right now. I can hear some of the rescue helicopters on the pad. There's no A-10s or 16s from Tucson Airport taking off right now, so it's quiet. So this is the street out in front of it. It looks like the junkyard kind of just keeps going out into the road. Unless that was a car accident that was staged for a movie set? I don't know. So the reason why that original shop that was in the first video is a no-go is because there is a body shop on site at that location that has a paint booth, and the owner of the property doesn't want a second paint booth on the lot because it could cause for competition with the other body shop. Problem with that though is we're not a body shop and the paint booth is gonna be just for our use. We're not taking jobs from paying customers. So we're kind of butthurt about that because it's not really fair. And we were willing to sit down and talk with that body shop and offer like sending them business from potential customers that want cars painted.
I was my favorite Jeff in the world. You're my favorite Jeff in the world.
You guys want him?
Sure. You want to be on camera, huh? So cute.
Are you a baby Jeff?
So next day, we're going to look at a vehicle for Celine because she doesn't have a car and she needs her first car. You're shy, aren't you? She doesn't like being on camera. She's camera shy. Anyway, we're going to look at something for her first car. So this is it. It's a 2001 Nissan Xterra 4x4 with a 5-speed manual, and it's black. It's the VG33 that's in here. It doesn't have any paint fade and it's black, which is really rare in Arizona. And it's a 4x4 with a 5-speed manual, which is kind of a rare combination for these Xterras. And the VG33 is a decent engine in here. So, AC work?
Yeah.
It does? Yeah, it's getting cool. Cool, it's got working air conditioning. It's got 4-wheel drive. It's got a little tear on the driver's seat.
Yeah.
Needs cleaning.
Yeah, a detail would do wonders on this thing. I mean, it sounds good idling. Looks like it's got aftermarket HID headlights, maybe. Turn the headlights on.
Yeah, it does.
It's got HID headlights. That's funny.
Okay.
Of course, because it's Arizona, this thing is completely rust-free. I just talked to the guy that owns this. He's the third owner. The previous owner was a girl that had this throughout high school and college, and her grandmother bought it brand new. It was garaged its entire life. That's why there's no paint fade on it. However, the clear coat you can tell is thin, obviously, because it's 01, but there is still no failure anywhere. Kind of shocked about that. I don't see any major oil leaks. It 100% needs a new clutch master cylinder and slave cylinder. Actually smells fairly clean in here. Just needs a little bit of steam cleaning and carpet cleaner. This will detail up nicely, I think, actually, too. No sunroof, slick top.
Like, dude, it's a four-wheel drive truck.
Yeah.
Everything works on it in Arizona. Like, I almost don't even feel like we should negotiate down. It's like the release point to the clutch is like right at the carpet.
Gotcha.
The clutches on these, because the way the front suspension is, I believe, is a nightmare to replace.
Mm-hmm.
Because fishing out the transmission is a huge pain because those suspension arms are under tension. I had to help a friend change a clutch on one of these before. And it's not hard, it's just an irritating clutch job to have to do. This is literally half of what her budget was, so it leaves half of a budget for buying parts and stuff for it. Either way though, like, this thing is $1,900. You don't buy a four-wheel drive truck with working air conditioning for $1,900 and have it be perfect.
It's not gonna lie, I would have a hard time trying to find something else after this. This is pretty sweet.
Yeah, this is not bad at all. It's got the old school rip it e-brake, like Toyota pickups. I didn't know Nissans had these too. Ta-da! I donned my Halloween costume. I'm Heidi from Home Improvement. You probably already saw the pictures on Instagram and my TikTok post, but we're back and we drove it for like an hour and the truck ran great, zero issues. You kind of lucked out. Like, so far that thing is solid for, she paid $1,800. So a lot of you know $1,800 for a truck that has working four-wheel drive, cold air conditioning, and a manual transmission, that's a good deal.
I'm curious to see what this thing is gonna look like fully washed and cleaned up. The bumper is so faded that it turned green and the fog lights are faded, but we can fix that.
You ready to learn how to detail a car?
Gonna hope so.
You know how to clean stuff, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
There's these little screw dads right here on the roof basket. There's four of them, and you undo it, and you can slide. Don't worry about the paint. It's already screwed up. You can slide it back, and then you can wash underneath here.
Oh, geez. That's gross.
This right here is a box of some stuff, the first round of stuffs that needs to be taken care of to make Celine's new Xterra reliable and good to go.
Made a list last night after washing it of a bunch of stuff that it needed.
After crawling under the truck, what I came up with is the valve cover gaskets definitely need to be replaced. They are leaking and they're running down the backside of the engine, so it's making it look like it's the rear main seal. So it might actually just be these. So replace those first. Both upper and lower radiator hoses are original, so those need to get replaced, as well as the thermostat. Clutch fan has some stress cracks in it.
The fan's got a crack right there. The fan's got little cracks right there. A pretty big crack right there.
So she'd probably replace that just because it's brittle and dry in Arizona. Intake boot is starting to crack, so I'm gonna try to look for one of those on like eBay or a junkyard. Clutch master cylinder, slave cylinder either need to be bled and or replaced. Also lower ball joints, both need to be replaced. The shocks are old and should be replaced. They're just kind of crappy. All fluids are gonna get replaced, obviously. New wiper blades, and lastly, a good detail job.
So here it is, after a wash. Last night, Celine washed it, and I helped out a little bit. But yeah, it's definitely got a lot of pinstriping from taking off-road. But we'll see what we can do to it. All in all though, it's surprising how decent shape this thing is in, considering it's got 260 something thousand miles on it. It's just a little bit of maintenance stuff, so it's really not that bad considering it was only $1,800. Should have a good running vehicle for a little under $3,000, I think, when everything's said and done.
You didn't actually think I was gonna put new wiper blades on without painting the wiper arms, did you? That looks much better. Now you don't have to worry about destroying your windshield glass with old crappy wiper blades missing the rubber.
You haven't even driven your new truck yet.
No, I have not.
We gotta do something about that. So, I think your bumper is missing a bolt or two. You're probably wondering why I painted this up here and not down here. This is plastic. This up here is metal. So I'm gonna try to treat the plastic or bring it back with a heat gun before resulting to using trim black on it. And if I can't, then I'll trim black it. I think this is gonna look good. I put the trim black gray on the upper part of the bumper, and I think it needs to go everywhere because I don't think I'm gonna be able to save that plastic and actually make it match. So I might just do all of it. And honestly, what do you guys think? Let me know in the comment section below. But Celine and I kind of both agree that if it was all black, it would just kind of disappear. So it's gray from the factory, it should be gray.
Gray all the way.
Figure you might as well go to a dirt road and practice there before you start driving it in traffic, just because it seems safer. So
yeah,
go ahead, drive. I'm not going to tell you how to do anything. Let's just, you should already know. So
see if I remember anything. That's the issue.
There you go, you're going. You did it. See, you can drive. So when you go to second gear, just go slow with it. Go slow into second when you push in the clutch and then second gear. The Ranger didn't have one of those. That's a tachometer. So see where it's at 1500 right now?
Yeah.
Pretty much you don't ever really want to go under that while you're driving down a road, because then the engine's going to start lugging. So see where your tachometer is at now?
Yeah.
You're still good.
Okay.
I mean, obviously you don't want to drive around at like 5,000 RPM, but... Celine is now driving in traffic on a road with other cars. Are you nervous?
Yes.
She's actually doing really good. We're in fourth gear and so far so good. I think she's gonna get this within maybe about a week and she'll be like on her own, good to go. I hear Celine coming. She's really shy. She doesn't like being on camera. I'm just gonna not say anything. Maybe she'll walk in here. Shy?
No, I didn't realize you were recording. I was like, oh, she's in the middle.
I was like, watch, she's gonna try coming in the door.
Well, I can't come in through the garage door.
The garage door is shut.
Exactly.
Anyway, Celine's got her first new vehicle. There'll be some content on that, obviously, on the channel. I mean, I still have content coming on this thing because I got a whole bunch of parts coming for it because there's gonna be a major overhaul happening in that vicinity, and obviously focus content. So now you have whatever her project is named. She disappeared again. She's so shy. She doesn't like being on camera. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and I will see you soon with another. Bye.